And lastly, my people who are happy, Sherry, Sherry! Sherry, Sherry! Sherry, Sherry! Learners, together with the teacher, sing a song about agriculture to tools. Now, we are going to see the generic contents created in that introduction. There is communication. Because learners and teachers sing about a song on agricultural tools. Because most teachers put communication and they go. No. Because the generic contents and cross-cutting issues to be addressed plus a short explanation. That short explanation must be related to teachers' activities, learners' activities, then to create that communication. And you give a short explanation. And when you reach here, you put GC first. Generic contents. Then you put communication plus a short explanation. Now we go to CCI, which means cross-cutting issue. Which cross-cutting issue will be included in that activity? We have gender education. Because all boys and girls sing a song about agricultural tools. Are we together?
Yes.
Now, most teachers make a mistake. Teacher sings a song, then they write a song in the lesson plan. That is wrong. A lesson plan is a guide. It's not a notebook. Then learners sing a song, then they also write the song. That is wrong. Teacher sings a song about agricultural tools and asks learners to sing it. Learners, together with the teacher, they sing a song about agricultural tools. Generic context is communication because learners sing a song about agricultural tools. Cross-cutting issue is gender education because all boys and girls sing about agricultural tools. Are we together?
Yes.
Now, for example, you don't have a song. You are not good at singing. What other activity can you use? Teacher demonstrates to the learners different agricultural tools and asks them to manipulate and identify their names. The learners' activities. Learners observe the tools, they touch, they manipulate as they identify their names. General competence is what? There is cooperation, interpersonal management, and life skills. Because the learners, together with their colleagues, they manipulate the agriculture tools displayed by the teacher. Cross-cutting issue is what? We have inclusive education. Because all learners in different categories, all different capacities of learning, they get the opportunity of touching and manipulating and identifying different types of agricultural tools. All together. Now, lesson, development of the lesson. In development of the lesson, we have three stages. We have the discovery activity. The learners must discover. Remember, in the lesson, we haven't introduced the topic of the lesson to the learners. You are still trying to make the learners to be familiar. But in the lesson discovery, that's where the learners now will discover what they are going to learn. Already I've given them the tools, now they are imagining in the head. Oh, maybe I'm going to learn about agriculture tools. Now,
No.
In the discovery activity, because our topic is about the common agriculture tools, the teacher displays again the agriculture tools plus their functions and asks learners to discuss as they identify the agricultural tool with its functions and asks learners to predict what they are going to learn. To predict is to discover. And ask learners to tell him or her what they are going to learn or what the lesson is all about. Because you have started with an activity. The teacher demonstrates again the agricultural tools with the different functions and asks learners to identify the tool as they match it with its functions and ask them what they are going to learn. The learners observe the agricultural tool as they match it with their functions and share the teacher the lesson they are going to learn. That is what we call discovery activity. Teacher's activity, then learner's activity. Are we understanding?
Yes.
I'm sorry for that. This is where the teachers fail. In fact, teacher asks a learner, then they put a question. What? Agriculture tools. Learner answer, then they put even the answers for the learners. That is wrong. Because a lesson plan is a guide. What have we prepared as a teacher? Teacher demonstrates the agriculture tools with the different cuttings showing their functions and asks learners to identify the agriculture tools and match them with their functions and ask them to share what they are going to learn. The learners observing the agricultural tools displayed, they match the agricultural tools with their functions and share the teacher the topic they are going to learn. Then generic competence, critical thinking, because the learners using the tools displayed by the teacher and their explanations, they match them as they share the topic they are going to plan. We have cross-cutting issue, environment and sustainability. The learners learn the agriculture tools used in different areas or in different environment. Are we together?
Yes.
Exploitation activity. In exploitation activity, this is where the teacher needs more information from the learners. And the teacher gives more activities which the learners will do so as the competencies can be developed. The teacher, using a case study, requests learners to read as they describe the category of agriculture tools. That is an activity number one. Activity number two, the teacher asks learners in pairs to think what they understand by agriculture tools. All together? Activity number three, the teacher asks the learners to draw the agriculture tools they have observed individually. That's where much information. Now, what will the learners do? The learners read the case study as they categorize different types of agriculture tools. The learners in pairs, they share the meaning of agriculture tools. The learners us individually draw the different types of agriculture tools in the exercise books. Generic competence. We have research and problem solving because learners read the case study as they categorize the different types of agricultural tools. We have also critical thinking because learners through share and pair, they think and share about the meaning of agricultural tools. Cross-cuttingism. We have peace and values education because through pair work of finding the meaning of agriculture too, each learner gives respect to everyone's opinion or idea. Another one, we have also gender education because all boys and girls answer the teacher's question about agriculture tools. All together. In synthesis activity, this is where the teacher comes in to give clarification, to give more information, to check if there is any mistake that the learners have been doing and wants to clarify. So here, in synthesis, the teacher gives more clarification about the common agricultural tools and asks learners to make their own summary. To pay attention and make their own what? Summary. The teacher gives clear understanding about common agricultural tools and asks learners to correct errors in the activities they have been doing throughout the lesson. What will the learners do? The learners pay attention to the teacher's clarification as they make corrections of their activities. Communication. Because the learners pay attention to the teacher's clarification about common agricultural tools. Cross-cutting issue. We have inclusive education because all learners listen to the teacher's clarification about agricultural tools. Conclusion and assessment. Remember the lesson plan we are doing is learner-centered. The teacher sets activities, the learners are the ones who do them. It is not the teacher who does, but it's the learner who does. Yeah. And in every step, you have seen there is assessment. That we call what questions. What questions will I ask students to check for understanding? Conclusion. In conclusion, we have three activities you are going to do. Number one. Teacher gives a summary note to support what the learners have been doing throughout the lesson. Summary! Another activity. Teacher gives homework and explains it to the learners. You give a homework and you tell the learners what to do about it. Because most teachers give homework and then learners don't do it because they don't know what they are supposed to do. So, teacher gives homework and explains about it. Another activity, teacher gives end lesson question. End lesson question to check if the objective has been achieved. There are how many activities? Three. One, teacher gives summary note to support what the learners have been doing. Two, the teacher gives homework and explains about it. Three, the teacher gives end lesson question to check if the instruction, if the objective of the lesson has been achieved. What is the learner's activities?
The learners write the summary given by the teacher in their notebook. The learners write the homework as they pay attention to the teacher's explanation about homework. The learners do the end lesson question and give her the book for marking. General competence, research and problem solving, because the learners think and research about the end lesson question given by the teacher. Cross-cutting issue, still there is it. Gender education, because all learners answer the teacher's end of lesson question. All together?
Yes.
Teacher self-evaluation. This teacher self-evaluation, most teachers make a mistake. They put lesson taught well. How? Good. How? Excellent. How? That's wrong. Because in the CPC, we want evidence of learning. If we say that the lesson was taught well, what shows? Where is the evidence? How many failed the lesson? How many failed? And what are you going to do to those learners? So that's why he said, because remember in conclusion and assessment, you have what you call end lesson question, which will determine whether the lesson has been understood. Have you met your instructional objective? That's when he said, out of 30 learners, 25 learners were able to answer end lesson question about the common agriculture tools. Why 5 learners failed? They will be assisted in remedial activities, or they will be given extra activities, or they will be integrated with other learners for discussion. Or this lesson is going to be repeated. You have showed the number of learners in the class, you have showed those who have followed, and you have showed those who have failed, and how you will assist them. That is what we call teacher self-evaluation. Now, evidence of learning, you have shown it. 25 learners were able to do this and this. How will you achieve? Well, how will you also help other learners who failed the lesson? You have also showed it using remedial activities, giving extra activities, also integrating learners with those who are excellent learners and those who failed for more discussion or repeating the lesson. That is how the lesson is supposed to be filled. So, don't put, teacher ask the learners, then you put the question. Rather answer, then you put answers. No. The lesson plan is a guide. It's not a notebook. It's not a summary book. But it is a guide. What the teacher must do and what the learners do. And in CBC, we focus on learner-centered approach. That's why our lesson plan is prepared according to learner-centered approach. What the teacher must do is to create activities and tasks of which the learners must do. Then you, as a teacher, you are a role model. You are a facilitator. You go moving around to see whether the learners are doing what you have given them. Are we together?
Yes.
Any question?
No question.
Any question?
No question.
Start up! We all clap together, all clap together. What do you have to sing when I sing like that? We all clap together,
we all clap together,
we all clap together,
we all clap together.
Clap, clap this way,
clap, clap this way,
clap, clap that way,
clap, clap that way.
We all jump together.
we all jump together.
We all jump together.
Jump, jump this way.
Jump, jump this way.
Jump, jump that way.
Jump, jump that way.
We all dance together.
We all dance together.
We all dance together.
We all dance together.
Dance, dance this way.
Dance, dance this way.
Dance, dance that way.
Dance, dance that way.
We all squat together.
We all squat together.
We all squat together.
We all squat together.
Squat, squat this way.
Squat, squat this way.
Squat, squat that way.
Squat, squat that way.
We all stand up together.
We all stand up together.
We all stand up together.
We all stand together.
Stand, stand this way.
Stand, stand this way.
Stand, stand that way.
Stand, stand that way.
We all face each other.
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 Now, tell me, tell your colleague what you have learned. Share what you have learned about the lesson plan. And how you're going to feel it, and how you'll make your lessons different from others. Yes.
I think this lesson plan is a very exciting
one. How will you feel?
I have gained some new methods how to feel this lesson plan.
Issues to be addressed within the content delivery.
Finally, I have suggested for the
description of teaching and learning activity. It's not a place to live from empty. We have to
think
that the things that we have to complete
they just can do together.
The way
we're not talking about sexual education, because also boys and girls really can just be
talking about and how that is
something to be the steps starting for development of the region.
But there's a short
for sure. It is new for us. We just discovered. Exploitation and also synthesis. Just the reason is just going to be now at the basis of the kids. Not only my guests, but just the interest is just on them, on the students, not for the society. Yeah.
Where are you brought the key in the topic?
Okay, thank you. What will you help other teachers? How are you going to implement this lesson plan in your daily activities as you plan your lessons? Yes. Yes.
So thank you for me. This lesson plan is very important for me because I have learned some new methods or ideas of how to fill this lesson plan Because before, there are some point that before I don't know, but he just now, after being trained, I have got the improvement. So I will share to my fellow teachers, different schools, according to that methods that you have told to us. Especially on the types of special education needs to be assessed on those students who have different types of special education needs. Also on the description of teaching and learning activity. I think that many teachers, they don't know how to fill that column. On the development also, discovery activity, exploration, and synthesis activity. Also, I have understood that there is the improvement on filling that, because it is where the teacher can be participating more compared to other parts. And on the conclusion and assessment, I understand that the teacher should give at least three sessions, if I can say. I mean, the first it is to give the more clarification on the what they have gained or she have given to student. The second it is to give the homework and how that homework will be done to students. The third it is to give the end unit questions, and so that the students should do them and present the papers or other methods they used for teacher for marking, and the teacher self-evaluation. This is how the teacher should assess him or herself to check if the instruction objective has been achieved by showing or demonstrating how many students have achieved the objective and how many they have failed, and the method or how he will assess or facilitate them after the lesson.
Wow. I want to give her imbuto. This imbuto or a fruit is a watermelon. This watermelon goes like this. Bigger as it is, you cut it.
Yes.
After that, you give it to her. Now we're going to give her the watermelon. 1, 2, 3, go. Cut it. Yes. Good. So that's the watermelon. Yeah. So in lesson development, the teacher sets activities for learners to do. The learners must do a lot, because the teacher wants to see the progress of learners in order the lesson objective to be achieved. Because this lesson plan is learner centered. Are we together?
Yes.
Yes. So please.
Point of appreciation?
Yes, please.
Mr. Brian, I would just like to appreciate the way you have just trained us about explaining the homework. Normally, the homework is not for teachers or for parents.
Yeah.
It's just for runners.
Exactly.
Therefore, once just you have explained to them, they're not going to be bored.
Yeah.
They just leave home, then they start recording what they have learned.
Exactly.
When they were at school.
Exactly.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you too.
Yeah.
I appreciate that. Okay, you can now sit down.
Thank you.
Yeah. Having looked at the lesson plan, having looked at all these steps, now let us switch our mind to the scheme of work. This scheme of work is very easy. It's the easiest. The most hardest is the lesson plan. But the scheme of work is just got from here, from the subject syllabus. It's just picking and feeling. Now remember, the only hardest part in the scheme of work which teachers fail are the teaching methods plus techniques rigorous evaluation procedures. And those are the teaching techniques they are asking you. In each lesson or in each unit, you are planning, you must have all these teaching techniques and approaches and methods. Now the question is, what is a technique? What is an approach? And what is a method? Who has the answer for me? What is a technique? What is a method? And what is an approach? Yes.
A technique is like a way to do something.
A
trick to do that can be used to do something.
Okay. Another one has a different view about technique. Yes, Donna.
I think a technique is the manner that you can do.
First of all, there. A manner. Give her flowers!
Flowers!
Technique, a manner. A plan. A plan. Good, a manner.
That someone can use. Maybe by using practice or by demonstrating.
A manner, a plan that a teacher can use to demonstrate, to practice in front of the learners. Good. A method. A method. Again, yes.
A method, I think it is in materials you can use by performing that technique.
The way, the behavior, the way you're going to do something, to demonstrate. An approach. Approach.
I think if it is for one, one people say, or if it is participatory.
The approach is the activity, isn't it? Yes. Now, these teaching methods, techniques, and evaluation procedures, we have them here. Because they help us to show how the teacher will do, or what approaches, what techniques, what methods will use in that lesson to develop the competencies of the learners. And it is from these approaches or techniques that will help the learners acquire the competencies, to acquire the knowledge, to acquire the skills, and so forth. And to these competencies that will tell us that the teacher is creative and innovative. Number one, we have round table discussion. I'm now with the component of a scheme of work about teaching methods, techniques, and evaluation. Round table discussion. For example, in the round table discussion, this is where the learners sit in the same way, and you pick a learner who sits in front of fellow learners, and then the other learners shoot him questions or shoot her questions in relation to the topic they have learned. As the learner is, they're asking the question, the teacher is now seeing the kind of questions being asked. The teacher is seeing how the answers the other learner is answering. And that is also assessment. And also that also promotes communication. It also promotes critical thinking and everything. We have questions in corner. In questions in corner, for example, in our lesson, we are talking about common agricultural tools. Questions in corner, I can ask, what do you understand by agricultural tools? In that corner, in another corner, name all agricultural tools. In another corner, I put categorize agricultural tools. And then another corner, explain the importance of agricultural tools. That is what we call questions in corner. The learners go and read questions. They discuss, even they summarize. They go to another question. We have outdoor activities. Outdoor activities like taking learners out of the class. They do home feasts to take those agriculture tools. They move around, they see the environment or other environment and the features around the environment they live in. Also those are field visits and outdoor activities. We have project work, we have group work, we have role play, we have case studies, we have brainstorming, we have a learning center or corner, we have games and play, we have research work, we have practical work, we have gallery work, which I talked about, we have a debate, we have Venn diagram, we have mind map, think, pay and share, go, more. All these are methods, approaches, techniques on how we do the evaluation procedure. I've not gone in detail to define all of this because it calls for a lot of time. But you can all search, they are all everywhere. Now, in the scheme of work, we are going to begin with academic year. Academic year is P4. Academic year is 2000 what? 2021. Yeah. Term, we said the term 2. School, GS Munyom. Academic year, 2021. Term 2, GS Munyom. Subject, science. Class or class combination. Class, it is P?
P4.
Number of periods per week. Number of periods per week is picked from the subject syllabus and behind they are here. If it is P4, science and elementary technology, P4, it must have 5 periods per week. Already it is indicated there. You don't imagine it. It is here.
Yeah.
So we say 5 periods. Date. Now we are going to make a scheme of work for 1 month. The scheme for 1 month, that's why we say now, for example, we started this term on 14th April. That's why we say from April 14th to 18th April, that is 1 week. Unit title, unit 1. Lesson title plus evaluation. Now, lesson title 1, where do you get it? From the syllabus. You write it. Lesson title 2, you also write it from the syllabus. Lesson title 3, you also write it. That is it. 1 week. Knowledge. Now, learning objectives. Learning objectives are also what from the subject syllabus, and they are categorized according to knowledge and understanding, skills, then values and attitudes. Are we together? And you pick them as they are. For example, in our unit 1, we have the learning objectives. We have knowledge and understanding, skills, attitudes and values. The topic is the common agricultural tools. Now, you and I pick one about knowledge. First, identify the common used agricultural tool. You put it here on knowledge. Skills. Draw and name different agricultural tools. You put it here. Attitudes and values. Display awareness about proper and safe use of agricultural tools. Or you pick one and put it there. They are picked. You don't create them. Teaching methods, techniques, and evaluation. They are here. On how you are going to teach these all these lessons. You can either use think, pair, share. You can either use mind map, you can either use round table discussions, you can use field visits, You can use group work, you can use brainstorming, you can use gallery walk, or you can use adbet. All those are teaching methods and techniques. Resources and references. You must use the way we have used in the lesson plan. What resources? Resources can be also teaching materials. You can use a panga, hoe, a slasher, an axe, a wheelbarrow. Then, reference, you must know the title of the book you are going to use, the year of publication. If it is a new edition, you put it. If it's old edition, you also put it. You put the author, you put the city of publication, and even the page. So everything matches with the lesson plan. Observations goes according to how we did it there. Yes. And say, according to the learners, according to 30 learners, in this week, these learners, 25 learners, were able to know, to draw and name the functions of the common agricultural tools, while 5 learners were able to name agricultural tools but failed to draw the agricultural tools. They will be given extra time to practice drawing. After making a general observation, this is 1 week. Are we together? And this observation is for 1 week because it has different lessons. Week 2, from 21st April to 25th April, we have lesson 4 and lesson 5. Now, most teachers don't know that we have a term called lesson bunching. In lesson bunching, this is where the lessons are put together which have similar characteristics or which can match together. For example, if I'm teaching about importances and types of agricultural tools and their importances, that is bunching lessons. But if I want, I could say types of agricultural tools. Then another lesson could be importances of agricultural tools. But if the lessons can match together, you can bunch. And that is what we call lesson bunching. You can say types of agricultural tools and their importances. So you will find that in this week, there's what we call lesson bunching of lesson 4 and lesson 5. Even in this week, there's what we call lesson bunching of these 3 lessons. Still in lesson 4, you again look at the content in the subject syllabus, you feed the lesson title, also you pick the knowledge, skills, values, they are also what in the lesson subject syllabus, and the techniques, they are here. You can use group work, you can use case study, you can use research work, you can use Google more, and so on and so. Mind map, field visits, questions in the corner, round table discussions, as you want, presentations, those are techniques. Resources and references, we have talked about them. Observations, you also make observations of that week. Now, week 3. In week 3, you'll find that from 28th to 1st May, from 28th April to 1st May, we have lesson title 6, lesson 7, and 8. But you'll find that this lesson title 6 is independent, depending on the length. My friend, that lesson is too big and it needs a lot of time. And then 7 and 8 can be bunched and be taught concurrently, all in line together. And that one, also the same, you have knowledge as learning objectives, skills, attitudes and values, and also the teaching methods, we have talked about them, resources and references, we have also talked about them, an observation. You also make an observation. Meaning that each week must have an observation for it, because learners learn differently and teachers teach differently. There's a week maybe when you feel you're sick. And then you say, the lesson 1, 5, and 8 were not taught because I was seriously sick. That's also an observation. Yes. Now, after a unit, making a scheme of work, after a unit, then we have what you call summative evaluation, to check if the unit, the whole chapter, or the whole unit has been understood. And that summative assessment or summative evaluation must be not more than 5 questions. Because some of you teachers give over 10 questions as if it is an examination. But in this summative evaluation is to check whether the key unit contents has been achieved. And that is where it is. Now, below here, we have under the learning objective, we have key unit content, and that key unit content is copied where? From the syllabus, and you write it here. Then, evaluation procedure. Evaluation procedure. How will you evaluate your learners in this unit? Are you going to use oral questions, oral activities? Are you going to use written by giving tests, by giving questions for learners to write or summarize, or are you going to use practicals? Are we together? Yes. Will learners draw? That is also practical work. So what procedures of evaluation? They are also here. So you specify. If it is oral, you say, I will use oral evaluation by asking learners such and such and such. All this is a scheme of work. For the scheme of work, you cannot do it without a subject syllabus. You have seen that everything is from where? From the subject syllabus. The easiest of all. And this is the format. After that, you start unit 2. Also, you begin afresh. The same, you apply you all these skills. Then you put summative assessment at the end, then key unit competence at the end, and then you show the evaluation procedures. Now, teachers fail to know the techniques. And these are the techniques, I've put them here. How will you use? Because you might find that the techniques you are going to use in this unit will be different from the techniques in the another unit, and also will be different in another unit, depending on how you understand them. Now, you can never develop a lesson plan without a scheme of work. The first is to make a scheme of work, and it's out of the scheme of work where you develop the lesson plan. Are we together? Yes. So, with that, thank you very much. I call for the end of my session, and thank you for paying attention, and thank you for following. Now I'm going to entertain questions, 2 or 3, where you think you didn't understand about the scheme of work, or where you need more explanation or clarification. Thank you very much.
1, 2, 3, go.
Thank you. Yeah, questions?
About today's learning center, learning corners. This was to be questions.
Yeah.
Now I want to, when are they going to be used? They are just there for evaluation, or just they can be used during lesson itself? Because you have seen to learn that each step of a lesson is also has an assessment.
Yes.
Yeah. So just to get more information about now. On each step, you go to visit the corner.
Yeah, in the learning centers or learning corners, they work specifically in nursery. Nursery class. In nursery, they must have the 6 learning areas. They have numeracy, literacy, then there is discovering the world, there is social and physical, emotional development, and so on. So these are put in learning areas, what we call learning corners. So the teacher must know, and those learning areas must be learned within a day, according to activities the teacher will have set. So even the teacher in the lesson plan, they have to make all those lesson plans and say, in the learning area of literacy, this. Numeracy, this. As the learners are doing, if others are in language or literacy, others are in numeracy, others are in discovering the world, as others are in emotional development and so on, so the teacher must be able to move around to see if the activities set for the learners to do, they are doing them and they are helping them to be develop numeracy, literacy, and also emotional development. Yes, according to the way he or she has prepared the lesson. Yeah, and I think I have much more content about the ECD, which needs another time for training, which if I would invite it out, I'll share it. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'll just say, wish you another goodbye song, a warm up, then we come back to call it the CEO to end the training. So yes.
About techniques, how can I use Gogomo?
Yes, very good. In Gogomo, I can ask a question. Isn't it? For example, I want to ask a question. Isn't it? Name the agriculture tools. When you say one, and then I say go, then you ask another one. Another one also says another, then you go, then another one says, then I say go, that is go, go more. Hey, you ask a question, the learner can answer, after they say, ask another one, another one to contribute, then after that, another one to clarify, and then another one to conclude, that is what you call go, go more. Hey. So everyone participates. That's also a technique. Yes. Okay, stand up. Okay. This one is just to make you feel lovely. Hey, it is feel lovely. Now, your phone. Everyone. Your magic. Because we want you to relax your mind from the content. Sometimes we need to a little bit.
Yeah.
Don't. But I'll first sanitize you. Try to first kill you down. Because we are going to. For you to say, Amba, 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 all of us.
Amba, 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 Amba.
That's what you always say.
Yes.
And I say, you say, Amba, 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 all of us.
Amba, 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 Amba.
Very good. Now touch your pattern. Yes. Anyway, that's because you're sanitized.
Okay. Sherry, Sherry. Amba, 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 amba.
Sherry, Sherry, where?
Amba, 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 amba.
Sherry, Sherry.
Amba, 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 amba.
Shoo, 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 shoo.
Amba, 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 amba.
Shoo, 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 where?
Amba, 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 amba.
Shoo, 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 shoo.
Amba, 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 amba.
Sweetie, sweetie.
Amba, 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 amba.
Sweetie, sweet way.
Amba, 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 amba.
Sweetie, sweetie.
Amba, 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 amba.
I want to put more dancing.
Like that.
Yeah. And lovely. Like people who are happy. Sherry, Sherry.
Amba, 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 amba.
Sherry, Sherry.
Amba, 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 amba.
Sherry, Sherry.
Amba, 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 amba.
Shoo, 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 shoo.
Amba, 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 amba.
Shoo, 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 shoo.
Amba, 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 amba.
Shoo, 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 shoo.
Amba, 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 amba.
Sweetie, sweetie.
Amba, 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 amba.
Sweetie, sweetie.
Amba, amba, amba.